I have a couple of questions. Can you explain the relationship between the PDA and the University of Pennsylvania Vet School?
Yeah, so our relationship, much like the Penn State relationship, I mean, they're a critical partner generally in protection of animal health. Penn has a unique position in the state, as you know, as a only veterinary medical school, which is critical to us, obviously, both in terms of the veterinarians, but also the access to, the staff and faculty and the diagnostics there. So as a general relationship, I mean, certainly valuing what comes out of from a student standpoint and a research standpoint. At a very practical level, the relationship in the animal health and diagnostic system, they're one of the three legs of that stool, and we talk about diagnostics, Penn State being the other. So the New Bolton Center is critical. Certainly the financial support for University of Pennsylvania is found in our budget as well, so there's certainly that relationship. But much like our discussion earlier about Penn State, we simply couldn't do what we do in the state for agriculture, production agriculture, without University of Pennsylvania.
Okay, thank you. And, at our hearing for the non-preferred schools last week, I asked Penn State about the ag research and the extension service, and he painted a really dire picture that they might have to start closing those systems down even by May 1st if there wasn't funding in place. I later spoke to Deputy Secretary Mike Smith, and he outlined for me the relationship between the land scrip and the funding for the non-preferred. And what really came really very, very clear to me was that this was, again, something, a valuable program that we're on the risk of losing. And I can't tell you how upsetting that is just because of the work that I saw Penn State doing in the city of Philadelphia. I don't represent the city of Philadelphia, but I live next door to the city of Philadelphia. They're across the street from where my district is. And the work that they've done in the food deserts in Philadelphia with teaching urban kids about agriculture, the farms, the farmers markets, I mean, it's just really compelling. So quite honestly, I was really very upset about that. And in all truth, I used to work at the University of Pennsylvania, and I got to know the vet school really well and some of the programs that they did. So I know the value that they also provide. I guess my biggest problem is, when you come back down to it, is that what we really need, and people have said this, we need the comprehensive budget, because, again, am I picking and choosing? As important as the programs that Penn State and University of Pennsylvania provide to the Department of Agriculture, and as important as agriculture is in this state, I don't live in one of the agricultural counties necessarily or in an agricultural area, but I like to eat. And
that's enough.
That kind of puts it at a really basic level.
Right.
And it's just incredibly important. And so I can see that, but I agree with my colleague, Chairman, when he spoke about we need to fund our public schools because they're really our preferred appropriation, and we have to fund them fully. And so, I was sitting here thinking as we were talking about how last June the governor made it very clear to the General Assembly that the budget didn't really respond. The budget that he was being presented, the budget that we were talking about that passed in June, was not a budget that he was going to sign. He was going to veto it. So we shouldn't have been surprised. We just shouldn't have been surprised when that happened. And then I foolishly thought that we would be coming back through the summer to meet and talk and that we would be passing a budget. And that did not happen. And it was a few days before Christmas when it finally seemed like there was a framework and there were going to be enough votes in the House to pass that bill, and it didn't happen. We, as Democrats, I remember being on the House floor, and we were told there were no more votes that day. We went and did a press conference, like, what's happening? We didn't really know what was happening, but we knew that there was no vote, And that was it. And then later that day, that was the day that the Senate then passed House Bill 1460, which the governor subsequently blue-lined and signed, which did not provide full funding. The governor has made it really clear to the General Assembly through all of these steps that his priority that he ran on and won, and quite honestly, the governor is the only person elected, well, who has a role in the budget process in Pennsylvania, who is elected by the people of Pennsylvania, not districts that may redistricted so that they favor incumbent legislators or parties or whatever. He won the state. He won by a good, solid majority. We all serve in individual districts, which we try really hard, I think, all of us try really hard to represent our districts. But the governor represents Pennsylvania. And so it's now March. What is it, March 9th? We have one more day of appropriations hearings. We're in session for 2 weeks, and then we come back. I think we have a week off, and then we're in session again. And yet, so we have time to actually do something. We have time to actually do something. And it would be, we can all pour our hearts out for all of the things that we would like to support. For me, I would like to support a budget that really starts with education and funds that, goes on to human services and the other needs in the state. And not in a small, any small part is the funding for the non-preferred universities and schools, the Department of Agriculture. I see all these kids from 4-H. I started to get, you know, again, I don't even know if I have 4-H in my district. I probably don't. But I see these young people who, you know, their school funding is in jeopardy potentially, but also this program that's so important to them is in jeopardy. So quite honestly, I thank you for being here. It feels a little bit like that game Jenga, where you pull out a piece that the whole thing may collapse and you keep taking chances. And I kind of feel sometimes that that's what we're doing, is we're playing Jenga and we've gotten lucky. Nothing has collapsed so far, but at some point it will. So thank you so much for being here. And I guess, yeah. If you have anything you wanted to add to
that. I would just say thank you, I mean, for your support of University of Pennsylvania and Penn State and the recognition that, you know, we need to find some solution here. I have been overwhelmed by the amount of support across the state for agriculture. You see it here, you see it every place you go. So I think, it's one of those issues where there is a lot of support, bipartisan support for ag and the ag issues. So let's hope that we can find that solution, resolution. Thank you.